Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon. So you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.
Before starting a section milling operation, the weld bore must be clear to allow passage of the BHA. The section milling BHA is then run in the hole to KOP depth. Typical accessories below the lock-o-matic include tapered mill, drill collars, jet sub can be run below the tool to clean the cutters or above the tool to enhance weld bore cleaning, and stabilizer. Typical accessories above the lock-o-matic include drill collars, shock sub, and drill pipe to surface. Collar position is then determined by idling the pumps and slowly slacking off until the knives bump the collar. With the section mill positioned just above a casing collar, rotation and circulation are started. The cutout process is now underway. Should pump limitations make a cutout difficult, a special washaway ball is dropped down the work string into the lower end of the lock-o-matic, creating a greater pressure drop and forcing the cutout. The ball is quickly washed away and the annular velocity is resumed. The section length can now be cut. With the section cut complete, the tool is then pulled out of the well. The cement plug is now set in the section itself. Next, the drilling BHA with AKO is run in the hole and the sidetrack is drilled. The drilling BHA is then pulled out of the hole. For underreaming applications, the lock-o-matic can be dressed with any type of roller cone, PDC, or bear claw cutters. The cutout into the formation is then made and underreaming is begun. After the hole is opened to the specified diameter, the lock-o-matic is pulled out and the well's completion phase is begun. Shown are the anchoring and milling assemblies that make up the window cutting system. The milling system consists of the whipstock, metal muncher window mill, lower watermelon mill, flex area, and upper watermelon mill. The entire WindowMaster BHA was refined using finite element analysis. The mills are attached to the whipstock by means of a shear pin. This attachment can be configured for either upshear or downshear, allowing it to be used in all retrievable and permanent applications. With the whipstock anchored in place, the mills are sheared free. The window is now milled. The drilling assembly is run in and finishes the new hole. The well's completion phase can now begin. We begin by running the Torque Master packer on wire line with the setting tool and casing collar locator. Readings are then taken at surface from the casing collar locator. The packer is usually placed directly above a casing collar. A signal is sent from the surface to activate the setting tool. The packer is then set, and the setting tool is pulled out of the hole. We now run a surface readout survey. The survey instrument is removed from the hole once multiple consistent readings are taken. While the survey instrument is being pulled out of the hole, the whipstock anchor is oriented at surface. An anchor, whipstock, and starter mill are now run in the hole. The starter mill is picked up and sheared free from the whipstock. The shear bolt remains attached to the starter mill. A starting cut is made into the casing and the lug is milled off the whipstock. The starter mill is pulled out of the hole. Next, we run in the window milling BHA. After the window is finished, the window milling BHA is pulled out of the hole. The drilling assembly is now run in to finish the new hole, and the well's completion phase can begin. The solid lug tool is run in the hole down to the whipstock slot depth. It is the simplest retrieval tool, is easily releasable, and allows for slack off to recock jars. The lug can be directly aligned with the whipstock using either the MWD or UBHO method. The jets built into the solid lug tool clean out the debris in the whipstock slot. The tool is then latched into the retrieval slot. The whipstock is then pulled from the wellbore. The rolling dog retrieval tool is run in the hole until it's just above the top of the whipstock. It is easily releasable and has a wide catch range. We begin pumping fluid through the tool to hydraulically roll the dog upward 90 degrees. Slow rotation and the cut lip guide are then used to get the tool over the whipstock. The fluid pump is stopped once the whipstock is fully inside the tool, allowing the dog to roll down and engage the whipstock. We then pull the whipstock out of the well. The special taper box tap with its wide catch range is run in the hole and positioned over the top section of the whipstock. The drill pipe is rotated and screws the special taper box tap firmly on the wide part of the whipstock and pulls it out of the well.